Department of Aging Rockers. Well, not really. I mean, he's in a class of his own, isn't he? Paul McCartney, age 71, still making vital, fascinating new music, even doing an impromptu concert in Times Square in the last few days.
And he showed up at a high school like 2 days before in Queens.
Does he just love this? So your argument, Mark Carrey, let's just talk about this. He is still at 71. As innovative as he ever was? Would you make that claim?
No, not as he ever was, but he hasn't been as innovative as he ever was in many years. But he's still innovative. He's making, like, actual music that isn't sort of embarrassing, which you would sort of expect from someone who's 71. And, I mean, Paul has his share of embarrassing albums. The new album called New is not embarrassing. There's some of it is very good. I've really enjoyed listening to it.
And his cover,
he's got four different producers on it. But I think that, and people are sort of making a big deal about that because he's sort of working with these, you know, quote-unquote hit makers who work with Adele and Amy Winehouse and Kings of Leon. But, you know, he's still in charge here, and he always covers a lot of stylistic ground anyway. But he's always been this idiosyncratic performer. Mm-hmm. And as much as people think, oh, there's Paul doing his stuff, like, nobody does what he does. And his albums are all weird. Like, there's always really weird. He's a weirder guy than people give him credit for.
That's the album where everything was, like, on the machine, right?
Yeah, McCartney 2 was that. But there's always stuff. But he's got some sort of this trancey stuff that's on there. He's got sort of some classic pop. I think that single New is actually the best single he's had in a couple of decades.
So if I've sort of vaguely followed Paul McCartney all his career, so this album, which you've listened to, where is he at now? Like, what does this say about him in terms of his career trajectory?
I think that he's gotten to this point where he's a little more self-reflective.
As you'd expect at 71.
There's a song about the Beatles experience, or right, that you don't know what I went through.
Yeah, it's called Early Days, and he's really sort of singing almost, I feel like it's almost sort of there's a huge Beatles biography coming out by Mark Lewisohn, who I think has the approval of these guys, and it's like 900 pages, and it ends in 62. It's going to be three volumes. It's like the Robert Carroll, Lyndon Johnson treatment of the Beatles, which they deserve, but the song is sort of like, you know, people have their say on who did what, but, you know, you weren't there,
right,
basically. Yeah. And I lived through the early days, and it wasn't all fun. And the way it's produced, Ethan Johns, who produces Kings of Leon, produced that one, and it's very stripped down, and there's a lot of effects on his voice and other ones. And this one, he just sounds kind of craggy, and it sounds like it was just like they just did one take. They didn't auto-tune a thing, and he has this kind of craggy, and it sounds really kind of honest, and it's cool. I don't know. He still has his points where he's doing his sort of little pop confections, but it cuts a little deeper now.
Do you ever wonder, like, how long can he go on? Like, is he going to be doing one of these? I mean, this is kind of a new thing for us. As somebody like him,
right,
at this age, is a sort of a new phenomenon.
He's a little bit of the eternal optimist. Like, he keeps getting married. He keeps, you know what I'm saying?
You've got to be an optimist for that.
Well, he also, it's like Dylan. Dylan never had like a pretty voice. I mean, Dylan's voice now is almost unlistenable. But 20 years ago, it was always Dylan's voice. But Paul had just this beautiful, smooth, clear voice. And now it's kind of quavery
in
there. And the way he's dealing with it is he's singing like a ton of stuff in this upper register, which is actually sort of harder,
yes,
but he's doing it anyway. Just like when he performs live now, he sings everything in the original key. You know, most of these guys, like Elton John, I mean, he sounds like a grizzly bear
compared to what he used to sound like. Right, no, that's a great
point. But Paul singing everything is in the same key, and even if it sounds like he's straining a little more, he just does it.